A very good morning to the respectable and honorable panelists, to all the diligent and talented student managers. My name is Akash Tiwari, and with me is my industry's friend, Ganesh Thawkar. We are representing the river Ganga. So, before I commence with my presentation, a quick question in front of you all. How many of you are bike lovers?
And how many of you are KTM and Bajaj lovers?
Okay, so that's certainly a great amount. And for those who don't like bikes, I'll make sure to take you along with me till the end of the presentation. The topic which we've chosen for today's presentation is case study on the acquisition of KTM by Bajaj Auto. The reason behind choosing this topic is since both of us are engineers, I being the mechanical and my friend being the electrical, and serving over for an year in the automobile industry, it may just be relevant to choose this topic. Now, there are 12 points which we'll be covering over in the next 10 minutes. So, I hand it to Ganesh.
So, salient features. Here you can see Bajaj Auto. It was founded in 1940 and 1940 in India, and its headquarters in Pune. It's manufacture two-wheeler and three-wheeler vehicles, and its parent group is Bajaj Auto. Now coming to the KTM. KTM was founded in 1992 and in Austria, and its headquarters in Mattighofen, and its manufacture motorbikes, sports car, and its parent company is KTM Industry. And these are the websites of respective KTM and Bajaj. Now, here you can see the photos of Rajiv Bajaj and Stephen Fierer. They are the CEOs of Bajaj and KTM. So, here is the main question. What was the need of acquisition? Firstly, for Bajaj, it is a good opportunity to enter in the global market, especially in Europe. And for it's a win-win situation for KTM also, because Bajaj hold a big role in Indian market, and it's very important and to set a goal, set a base in Indian market for KTM. And whenever the two companies are collab with each other, there is the exchange of technology, so it's helped to increase the efficiency of their products. Next. So you can see here the products of Bajaj and KTM. There is a Bajaj products are Bajaj Avenger, Pulsar, Discord, Platina and Dominar. And here you can see the KTM products are KTM RC 125, 200 Dukes, 125 Dukes, 390 Dukes, etc. Next. So, here, market share. The Indian market of two-wheeler is 2 crore 11 lakh and 81 thousand units. Here, you can see the 12% market share of Bajaj Auto in 2019 compared to 9.8% in 2018. Here, you can see there is an increase of 28.7% market share. In this slide, you can see Bajaj Auto has increased market share 28.7%. It's the biggest in the major companies, and these are the competitors: Hero, Honda, and TVS. So, revenue in 2018, revenue of Bajaj Auto is approximately 27,000 crore, and in 2019, it's 32,000 crore approximately. Next.
Okay, thank you, Ganesh. I take from here onwards. So, with me is the 12th annual report of Bajaj Auto Limited, and I would request the committee member to kindly forward this to both the panelists. So the marketing strategy of every company depends on how they forecast themselves. And trust me, Bajaj Auto is very good in this. So they have laid down four factors. First one is the rally, YouTube, TV advertisement, and hoardings. Now on the right side of you, you can see a rally being organized in Mumbai this very year. So, because of their significant marketing strategy, you can see that in the year 2017, they were only able to sell 7,399 bikes, which took a steady growth to 50,075 in the year 2019. Isn't that amazing? So, here is the quick question in front of you all, and let's see who answers it first. And the question is, who do you think is the boss of a company? Anyone? Exactly. Right. The customer is the boss of a company, and I appreciate your sincere comments, and we want to offer you a small gift. Can you please forward this silk? Okay, so the customer review matters a lot in the company's growth, and hence we have brought with a video. The video is of 1 minute 7 seconds, and I request all of you to listen it carefully. The sound may be quite low.
Chalo.
Okay, hello sir, what's your name?
Akshay.
Okay sir, so when you purchased this bike?
Yeah, this model is of 2017.
Okay, 2017.
Yeah.
So since then, what other things you think find is very good in this bike?
Okay, before purchasing the bike, the only thing in was in my mind is the RPM. That is the power the bike gives. It's very nice, a lot power, 9000 RPM, 27 BHPs, and it's all good, you know.
Okay sir, that's nice. And what all disadvantage we find in this bike?
Okay, disadvantage, there is no any disadvantage such like that, because this bike is made for the racing purpose. But yes, if we take anyone to the second hand, if someone sits on the set, on the back seat, so it will be hard to carry and to maintain the balance.
Okay sir, okay. And what all rating you want to give in this one? Out of 5.
Okay, if you ask me for the rating, then I'll give it to 3.5 or 4.
Okay, yeah. Sir, thank you for giving us your time. It was great talking to you.
Sure.
So Ganesh was the one who was taking the video, and I apologize for those who are not able to clear, and that's why I want to brief it. So I had a word with the customer, and I put forward 4 questions in front of him. The first one, when did he purchase the bike? The second, what are the advantages and the disadvantages of the bike? And third one was ratings. So to this he replied that he purchased the bike way back in the year 2017. To the advantages, he said that the bike has a sleeky body, and there was a good color combination of black and yellow. A bike has a very good pickup, that there's an accelerator, and it reaches up to 80 km per hour, and that in 6 seconds. And it has top 6 gears. For the disadvantages, he said that for short height people, and maybe for some women, it might be a problem. And hence, he gave a rating of 3.5 out of 5. So, way forward, since you saw the KTM growth rapidly, and as a result, they are manufacturing 2.5 lakhs in the year, financial year 2020, out of which 1 lakh will be made here in India and export to different foreign countries. Now, coming to the conclusion. As a result of this, as a result of the acquisition, Bajaj Auto gained a significant profit being acquired after acquisition with the KTM. Why? Because it was initially in the year 2007 when they purchased 14.5% of the shares with KTM, which rose increasingly high to 48% in the year 2016. Now, coming to the source of information, we both would like to thankful Maharana Ray, the vice president and of Bajaj Auto Pro Biking, and he was one of the guest lecturers. We want to thank him sincerely for helping us in the best possible ways. Now coming to the reference, these all are the slides from which we gathered the information, and we are able to present a presentation before you all. So this is all what we want to say in front of you. Thank you for hearing us. Thank you once again.